always do.
The singing
and
intro.
You. What's going on, everybody? Tuesday night here in the Roy and Jimmy Thing, chaoticradio.com. Don't forget to download the app. Jimmy Shaw, what is going on, my brother?
We are the Roy and Jimmy Thing, our Tuesday night ritual in Rancho Cucamonga. How was your week, my friend?
Man, my week was amazing.
Amazing.
Amazing. I mean, I got through it. I lived. I'm another week older.
That is a fantastic week.
Yeah, I didn't hurt anything. I didn't fall down. I didn't, you know, no doctor's trips. I'm like, come on, bring it.
And no one hurt you.
That's good.
See?
That's good.
All good.
How was your week?
Not bad.
Yeah?
Not bad at all. Yeah, just moving forward with stuff.
Moving forward.
Moving forward.
Better than going backwards.
Yes, I start my new job tomorrow.
Yes, you do.
I had an orientation on Friday.
Did you learn anything?
I learned that I'm an idiot for owning my own business all these years.
Yeah, well, you know, there's that.
They're throwing benefits, throwing money at you. The first half of this orientation, they were just talking about benefits. And so far, I've got a shit ton of unpaid time off. I've already got paid time off hours. I've got vacation hours already.
Already?
Already.
All right. Where do I sign up for this shit?
And benefits. I don't have to wait 90 days. I'm already covered.
Wow.
So
what are you going to get fixed first?
I think I need more than the lube and tune right here.
You got to get something fixed.
I need a specialist under this hood.
You know, I went to the deal a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
I was just talking to Blaine before the show. I think my bill was like $9,000-something.
The actual bill you would have to pay?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not paying that shit.
Right.
You know.
I was stunned. I actually told Blaine. I talked to him after you did, apparently.
Yeah.
And I told him, I said, I was pissed. I was driving home Friday going, son of a bitch. Wasted all that time owning my own business.
Yeah, but the country's built on the small business owner, Jimmy.
Yeah, well, they killed me, so I'm going to ride on the back of them right now. I'm just going to shut up, do my job, and get paid. I'm going to love it.
That's badass, though. I mean, that's cool. Well, good for you because you're starting, you know, getting some stuff. And I just want to know what you're going to fix first. You know what? I don't want you to tell me.
I'll see if you notice.
I want to see if you notice that things are getting
fixed. See if I have any plastic surgery or.
I don't know. Just see if you walk any different or you're a little taller, your smile's brighter, or new glasses.
I'll get those teeth like Matt Dillon and something about Mary.
Oh.
The big old chiclets.
Oh. I
have some big old horse teeth in the front.
Yes.
That would be awesome.
But we could do that thing every week. We could do like, guess what Jimmy got fixed every week.
What were Jimmy's benefits this week?
Right, because it wouldn't be anything that, you know, it would have anything big, but it'd be nice if we could notice.
See if someone notices.
Right. See, it's like, well, was it worth it or not? See if you got a little spring in your step.
See if anyone notices, and it may be nothing.
Oh, and then you can catch them if they're full of shit.
Right. Might be a placebo thing. Say, oh, Jimmy, you know, you do look better.
And you're like,
really? Are you working out?
No, that's not it.
Yes.
No gym membership and the benefits.
Exactly. That would be fun. Well, that would be fun to fool friends and family.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe not.
A little bit.
Yeah, whatever. I don't give a shit.
Well, we do have our guest, Erik Escobar. He's going to be in a little later.
Yeah.
That little grinder's out there at the Burbank Comedy Festival tonight.
So he's going to come all the way from Burbank to come out here and see us.
Yeah, well, he hit me up last week and says, 2 weeks ago, he says, I'm in town and I want to be on the show. So I said, this one's yours, so.
So he's in town in Burbank.
In Burbank.
That's not like in town.
The area. Well, he's up north now. So
no, I know. I know he's up north.
SoCal would be in town for him.
But yeah, see, he's driving that far from Burbank after grinding it out because he wants to see us.
He wants to be on our show.
Right. Yes. See?
He wants the return, the triumphant return.
See?
Yes.
Everybody listening, do you understand what we're saying? He sees the value in the Roy and Jimmy thing here.
Value added. Yes.
Right. I mean, you can drive all the way out here from Burbank, burn all that gas.
To go only half the show.
Half the show and lose some sleep.
That's our boy.
Right?
Yes.
I think he wants to sit on a big couch out there. It looks like a biscuit.
We're going to have to let him.
Yeah.
We'll let him take like 10-minute power nap before he drives back.
No, because I got to go home and go to sleep. Sleep outside.
Yeah, we both have jobs now, so get out of here.
Jobs, dude. The day job.
Yes, sir.
I told Don before I left tonight, I'm buying a lotto ticket tomorrow.
Really?
I'm feeling pretty good. Yep. And then I decided I'm going to buy two.
Oh, getting daring. Why? What's the inspiration here? What are you doing?
Well, you only need one to win, right?
Right.
So I'm thinking, all right, one. And I said, no, two, because a quick pick and numbers you pick. That way you got all bases covered.
Gotcha. Both
and
ends.
Then I thought, wait a minute. I'm going to buy two, but I'm going to buy two with the numbers I pick. The same.
Yeah.
So they had exact same numbers twice. I am.
Okay.
Yeah. So that way, like, if I win, my numbers win.
You're going to share with you.
No. Yeah. But if another person wins.
Right.
Guess what?
You get 2/3.
You see what I'm saying?
Corner the market.
That's right. Can you imagine doing that to some guy? And you buy five and you do them all the same. And one dude says, oh, man, what happened? It's like, oh, wow, six people won? Man, I got to split it. No, I got 5/6.
Yeah, I was going to say, we have 3 winners. He's like, yes, and then you're the 2.
I'm the other 2. What if I did 5 and I was 5 out of 6? He gets a little bitty chicklet, and I get all my millions.
I don't know if that's going to work that way.
It would work that way. I've got 5 tickets. They're going to have to pay me 5 times.
So you're saying the separate ticket is the piece of the pie?
Right, because I have 5 winning number. I have 5 winning tickets. That means I get 5 out of, there's 6 winners. I get 5 out of 6.
Okay, I see your point. So each ticket being a claim.
Right.
No matter if it's the same you and the same numbers.
Right.
Oh, look at you.
See?
So you're muscling out the odds. You're not really increasing your odds of winning, but nope. You're muscling out the share odds.
Right. Because if I'm going to win, I mean, come on. It's lightning in a bottle. If you're going to win, you're going to win a number. It's going to be your time.
Exactly.
But if I'm going to win, now I get almost all of it.
5 shares out of 10, 5 shares out of 6. Gotcha.
So say it's $100 million.
Right.
Okay. And I get a ticket and he gets a ticket. That's easy. That's, you know, $500 million apiece.
Right.
I mean, it's not going to be that much. It's 80 million or something now.
Sure.
So it's 40 million apiece. So now I have 5 out of 6. Ain't 40 million.
And you muscled out the other guy's share.
Right.
Okay. I like the thinking. I like it.
And he's going to be pissed off.
That would be something.
And I'm going to walk in with all 5 tickets, go, it's me. Huh. I wouldn't gloat. Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, you would.
You're like, you should have thought of my strategy. And if you were listening to the Roy and Jimmy thing on Tuesday nights,
you would have known it.
You would have had the inside track.
And you could have done. You could have prevented this.
It's your own damn fault. Chaotic Radio is free on the internet. You get it. It's live.
The internet and the fantastic new chaoticradio.com app.
Right. Awesome app. And if he couldn't listen tonight, he could have listened to the podcast starting tomorrow morning because Jimmy's on it and gets it up first thing in the morning.
And still have a chance to get into that super lotto.
And still have a chance to get in before 7:30.
All right.
So it's not my fault.
So mystery winner here has 2 shots and he doesn't know it.
Yeah.
To increase his odds.
So right now what I'm thinking, if he doesn't do that and I do, dumbass.
There you go. He's been warned.
I told him.
This is nationwide. This is worldwide.
So. Worldwide.
So lottery winners just sitting there ignoring it.
You can call in a ticket from out of state. You can call in and have someone buy a ticket here if you're in over the pond. I don't care.
Over the pond.
Across the pond. Over the pond. Over the river and through the woods. I don't care where you're at. That's where I was going. I was going to grandma's house, and that's where I was at.
I understand.
So there it is. So
very good.
You know the odds.
You know what
I think I'm going to do?
What?
When I win? I think I'm going to talk to Blaine.
Yeah?
Yeah, because I mean,
you want to be the new CFO?
No. I don't want to. I don't know. I don't want that.
Yeah,
but I would think it'd be cool if it was the Roy and Jimmy Chaotic Studio.
Already naming it. As long as it doesn't have Memorial underneath it.
I think he'd be okay with that if dropped a mill on him or something.
Hey, if you dropped a mill on Blaine, I'm pretty sure.
Well, I'm not saying a million.
You give him a million.
Some tens of thousands.
You give him a million. It would be the Roy Brewster Show, 8 to 11 live, hosted by Blaine Humbles.
No, here's the thing. I want no part of that. That dude works too hard.
I'm just saying, title only. Just put your name on everything. The Roy Brewster Bathroom, the Roy Brewster Studio A. He said about 1,000 might do it.
1,000? Man, he could have held out.
Throw him 5 digits. At least go 5.
No, I'd go more than 1,000.
Go 5 zeros.
This damn place has been so good to us. I'd maybe more than 1,000.
Speaking of the bathroom, I went in there last week, and I wasn't prepared for the Disco Strobe show. When I went in there, that was badass.
Yeah, except for when you're looking down at your junk.
If you're standing, it's a little crazy.
Yeah.
Sitting, I'm sure it's entertaining.
Yeah, you just don't want to leave as you're looking at the no fap zone sign on the wall. Like, whoa, I almost need to.
It does glow in the dark.
Yeah, you almost have to because, that's the way it is.
That's it. All right, you said I don't have any gigs coming up up in the next couple weeks. You do, however. What do you got coming up?
I will be at the Brea Improv September 1st.
Tuesday, September 1st. We'll be off the air for that. We'll go dark honor of the big man on the Brea Improv. That's Eddie Jarvis's show.
Yes, it is. Friend of Chaotic Radios.
Yeah, absolutely.
Don't ask me.
Who else? Don't ask you? Okay. It's on the flyer.
It's on a flyer. Check it out.
But you haven't been to Brea in a long time. And I know that's one of your favorite spots to perform. I love that place.
Yeah, I was doing Brea a lot, monthly.
Yeah, you were working down there. You were actually, that was kind of your area, your fans. So a lot of people are coming up. I saw your posts and everyone's saying, yes, for I admire your fan base because you get so much support when you do shows like that.
And it's cool to all of a sudden people saying, hey, I had a shout out from Northern California today.
No kidding. Nice.
They said, get your ass up here. I'm like, well, okay.
Very good.
I posted a picture and I put back, when I first started.
Yeah.
And she said, I put, who knew, blah, blah, blah. And she said, you forgot hit him, baby.
That's like, right. Wow, I saw that.
That's a fan.
That's it. Yeah, exactly. That's why that's why consistency is so important. If you post before a show, then you post after a show, you have to do that.
Right, and I'm thinking I need to sign out that way at night now. Hit him.
Well, yeah, when you do a post out or something like that, just make that yours, and obviously that is yours. You derailed from it, and someone called you out on and said, hey, Roy.
Yeah, you forgot.
You forgot. It's like when I go to do a show and I put the hashtag Jimmy Time. Well, someone's going to put down Jimmy Time with a question mark, and I'm like, whoop, I did that. That's my thing.
You know what's funny is I almost put, when I put that thing up, I put rookie. I was almost put rookie season. I went, no, that Jimmy does that.
Oh, that's...
But I mean, that's why I understand. You wouldn't have been like, who cares?
Right.
I know you, but it's like, no, that's Jimmy's thing.
Oh, gotcha.
I'm like, I can't do that. So I just put rookie.
I appreciate that, buddy.
Because it's not right. So if you're listening to Melissa Sheffield Lawson, I'm giving you a shout out right now. You should be listening because you're the one that said
on air live shout out.
She said, you forgot hit him, baby. I was like, wow, I forgot. No, I don't do that shit anymore. That was a good cough button, man. Good job.
Thank you very much.
Did you cough or sneeze?
It was a cough.
Oh, I just checked.
Yeah.
But see, we're such pros.
I know where the buttons are.
Didn't even know.
The right buttons, Matt Aldridge.
Ooh. Wow.
he's staying on me, and I need somebody on me because I did not realize I shut the studio down. I didn't shut my show down. I shut the studio off.
Once.
For like 8 hours, 10 hours, the studio was black, dude. It was dark.
Once. I mean, one time, they don't let you forget.
It was a good one.
It's kind of like in elementary school, shit your pants one time.
Your shit pants.
That's it. You hope
your shit pants, your skid mark, your diarrhea breath, whatever it is.
All of
yes,
it.
Yes.
And it's like no one else ever did that.
Exactly.
I've done it as an adult. I mean,
did it before I got here.
I worked it out a little bit. I got on my special Oakley shoes.
I saw those. Those are dashing.
I know. They're awesome.
I like them.
I know. Someone at home doesn't.
Because
they make my cankles look bigger.
Well, like I told you, the only thing that will make your cankles look smaller are pants.
That shit ain't right. I'm starting to get a bone on my ankle.
You
all
said
right?
you so felt, stop. Yeah, you said you saw something.
Yeah, I thought it was swell. I thought I twisted my ankle or something. It's like, no, it's a bone.
You got a shadow above your foot.
Yeah. So I must have got some dirt. A little dirt on the side of my leg.
Scrubbing it and scrubbing it, realizing it's actually your ankle bone.
It's my ankle. I was sharing.
You gained an inch again. You gained one down there.
See, yeah, I don't need a tail.
Yeah, well, you said every inch every pound you lose,
right?
Inch you gain,
right?
Well, your front side, obviously, but there's also, your ankle bone, ankle bone. You're gonna start feeling like your tailbone, like you said.
Oh, that's not even that happened. I shared that before. We're talking about a cankle. We came on the air, being 490 pounds before. And I got to tell you, I'm 200 down now. I mean,
that's
officially.
Amazing.
So when I, like some point around 140 or 50, I'm in the shower washing up and I get around, around the top side of my back, just above my butt, washing up.
Yeah.
I got a tumor.
Oh my God.
I got a tumor. I'm going to call the doctor. I got a tumor. That's your tailbone, dumbass. You never felt it before, so I didn't know what it was. So, you find things, more than one thing on a body when you lose, any to outie, obviously in the front, but.
So when you get down to your target weight, you're going to feel like a porn star.
Oh, please.
Please. You don't have to move anything aside to glance at it.
No, yeah. No. I got to move aside. And it's, I do the thing about an inch for 20, 20 pounds, but that ain't it. But we know it all. It's an angry inch,
it's
right?
It's an angry inch.
Angry. Get it.
Nice.
This thing's going to hell in a handbasket.
Nice. Well, look, we got some time. Like I said, Eric's going to be here around 10 o'clock. Let's get to your usual, buddy. Where's our list? What do we got going on, buddy?
Okay.
Take it away.
Today is Bad Poetry Day.
Today?
Yeah, today only. So we could write poetry today. I don't know if it's... What kind of poetry is it? If it's a haiku or not? I don't know.
I don't know the difference, but bad poetry on both ends. So you would be excused for writing it or publishing someone else's.
Right. Publishing someone else's. Well, you've heard about that shit going on with that guy.
Yeah, you can post it, though. I'm just saying it's allowed today. You know, so if someone reads a poem I put online, it's like, holy shit, Jim, that sucks ass. It would be okay.
Just like glass.
Exactly.
It's Sunday and I'm going to mass.
Look at you rhyming.
See what I did? I'm busting some rhymes.
You're busting rhymes.
Busting rhymes. Because it's about times.
So today...
we're going to get all this up.
So today only I would not be...
It's going to pay me dimes.
It's okay if I... See, that's some bad poetry right there.
Right there. Busting some...
Or bad rapping. It just goes for stuff that
rhymes. Don't you know I need a biscuit? Jesus. It's better than a Triscuit.
Yeah, and I can't dog you on this. It's perfectly allowed today.
Today? Whoa. You just said it was bad.
Yeah.
Today. I thought you said I was busting some rhymes.
Yes. It's pretty horrible, but it's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay.
I'm not gay. So you can go away.
Please stay away from the rhymes, okay?
Maybe another day. Okay.
But today's okay.
Today's okay.
There you go.
Yeah. My name's not Jay.
That's about as hard-ass freestyling as we're going to do.
We just freestyled some shit right there. It wasn't even a bit.
What other things we got?
It's birth control pills day, so everyone, if you're taking them, don't forget to take it out a little round thing. You don't want to get the guy stuck.
That should be every day.
Should be every day. Every day is birth control.
Is there a special on them today?
Today's the day, though.
You can tell your parents you're doing it, and it's okay.
I don't know what they mean by it.
I don't know. My problem is, obviously, I think they're frivolous, these whatever official days are.
We still need
a day. Where's the advantage of it? For that person, the bad poetry, the birth control pill day. What does that mean?
The advantage of it today, by the way,
asshole,
is that we were allowed to do our little rhyming.
Right, but okay, so go to birth control. This is National Birth Control Day.
We could have just saved somebody from an unneeded pregnancy by mentioning it today. Because someone might have went, I take my birth control pill at night. I don't know when you take them, but I forgot. I'm going to take it.
Well, is there a special on them? Do you get two for one?
I don't know. Is it true that all the pills aren't the pill, but you got to take them to keep on? I heard that they all don't have, like, some of them are bullshit, and then the one pill, you don't know which one it is, but you got to take them all the time.
Oh, a placebo effect again. Yeah.
I heard that. I don't know. I don't know what it is.
Personally, I don't take them, but from what I've read in our vast number of years on this earth, you can't miss a day.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
It's a constant dosage.
Right.
If it's Russian roulette, that's kind of fun.
Go.
Right?
Yeah, not if you're the guy.
Little risky?
Little risky. It's not risky if you get in there and get them things cut off. I did that. I'm manned up.
But when you're thinking they're going, is this the real one? Is not the real one? You still have to take it.
Right.
That adds a little something to your brain there. A little
intrigue.
A little suspense to your life.
I don't like the suspense.
Well, they're making it fun. So National Birth Control Pill Day.
Yes.
Congratulations, ladies. Keep taking the pill. You get nothing for it except, like the other days, no baby.
It's
there's no free flags. There's no free food. You can't go to Denny's and get anything free.
No, but it's a day.
It's just recognized as this day is that day. As the other 364 should be.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. It's National Aviation Week. This is out to you, Gary.
Aviation Week. Okay, that's something I get on board. Sure. We're celebrating aviation.
And aviation, they do it in the week of the Wright brothers' birthdays or some shit.
See, that all makes sense to me.
It says Aviation Week. National Aviation Week. I just already looked it up. National Shit, I lost it. Oh, well. Dead air. Beautiful for you.
So, National Aviation. Like I said, celebrating the miracle of flight.
There we go. National Aviation Week. Always the week of Orville Wright's birthday. His birthday's on the 19th, which is tomorrow, so that makes it this week.
So Wilbur's ass out?
You know... I'm thinking because
he pushed it and
Orville
was in there.
I think he was the other Wright brother was just flying on his coattails.
A good one.
You know what? That's what I did there.
I love what you did there. A little freestyling, a little on the spot.
It's also National Massage Therapy Week.
Massage Therapy Week. Okay, now I can go. I'm a little more. You know how I don't like these national things. These days of.
I know we don't like them until we get our own.
But the week thing actually makes a little more sense because, you know, you got a Monday through Sunday thing going on. It's like, okay, all week long, we're celebrating National Massage. Okay, fine. Go get a massage, everybody. You have all week.
And I bet if you go to Massage Envy, they might have a special this week.
If you have National Massage Day and you're busy, you're missing out.
Right, but you got 7 days to get it worked in.
You can celebrate it in any form you want.
Right.
Give a massage, get a massage. Whichever. You have 7 days to do that. And if you're lucky enough to do all seven, boom.
Oh, seven massages.
But you only got 1 day. We're working. It's a Tuesday. Obviously, we're on the air.
Kind of tough.
Then you might be ass out. So by the time you get home, 8 o'clock at night, eat dinner, you're too tired.
All the massaging I'm doing is on myself. You know what I'm saying?
So what'd you do for National Massage Day? I got home late. I was pissed off. I went to bed.
But what you needed was a massage so you wouldn't be pissed off, but you weren't in the mood.
And if it was all week, you would have had time to enjoy it.
Okay.
Okay. That's what I'm sticking with that.
I'm good with you.
Okay. So what do we got? So National Massage Week?
Yes.
Okay. Where's our countdown?
No. Because we have month.
Go.
It's National Breastfeeding Month.
All for that. and that's all month.
So
all month of August?
All month of August.
So we only got a few days left.
Yeah, you could whip that booby out and feed your baby whenever you
there,
want.
Go out there, fans, and celebrate with gusto.
Yeah, I don't know.
And if you didn't know, now you know. You have to put 30 days into five.
Yeah, because you got to work it in now.
Yeah.
Right.
You've got to try and schedule that in.
So if you're
until next Saturday.
So if you're on the bus and you need to, you know, there you go.
If you see someone breastfeeding.
Nice, Jimmy. You tell it's your month. You do it whenever the hell you want.
Stand guard. Make sure no one's leering
at
her. Do your part.
Damn right. Put up the block.
Put up the block if you need to, but be on the lookout. Don't let no one stare.
Because it's their month.
Right.
And if they would have paid attention. And if it was a while ago, like 9 months ago, the National Birth Control Day, they wouldn't have been breastfeeding now.
Exactly. So show a little respect.
A little respect. That's why they can't be in the same, like, that's why they're on the same day. Otherwise, it would, like, contradict themselves.
Exactly.
So, it's national, the last one I have today is National Panini Month.
Oh.
I love me a panini.
Panera Bread, panini. Oh, you know the best panini I've had.
Uh-oh.
It's a meatball panini.
I'm already in.
At the Corner Cafe or Corner Bakery. Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Oh, is that a meatball? Oh, my God.
I don't like you.
It's awesome.
I don't like you at all.
And they do it panini style.
I don't like you.
It's not me. I just ordered it.
No, you brought it up. You realize I'm not having any bread still.
Well,
I can't have a panini with no bread.
You said panini. You could have dropped this off. I'm not looking at any notes. You could have not mentioned the panini.
I had to because I'm a masochist.
I know. And it's what you do.
It's what I do.
It's National Panini Day. You couldn't skip over it. You were a professional. You carried through. You bowled right through this.
That's exactly where I was going with it.
Kudos to you, buddy.
I'm going
to
sacrifice myself for the show and the listeners.
There you go.
That's what I do.
You gave your all.
And as do you.
There you go.
Even though you brought up that meatball shit.
The meatball panini.
You didn't have to push it over the top.
When you're done with the bread thing, if you ever are, if it ever comes back to, or if you have friends who ask, hey, where can I get a good panini?
I'll say, ask Jimmy. You know, I ain't telling you.
You know what? Haven't had it myself, but try. I hear the panini meatball sandwich at the Corner Bakery is the bomb.
Is to die for.
Exactly.
I think there'll be one time, at least once in the rest of my life, that I'll probably bread will pass over my lips.
Okay. When it does.
And I bet it'll be at communion.
It should be. That should be your first bread stop.
Right.
That should be your first one.
Body of Christ, amen. If I went into church right now, it'd explode.
It would explode on you?
Yeah, it'd go over. So National Breastfeeding Month, the National Panini Month.
Okay.
We're going to welcome Erik Escobar. If you want tickets, hit me up. I got some free guest list stuff that might be out. I'm going to get some hard tickets, too. So if you want to see me, I'll throw those at you.
Nice.
And we ready for today? I love this part.
Go.
I don't even care if anyone else does because I lose.
Do it.
I'm looking down.
This is our time. Go.
Ready? 135 days.
To the end of the year.
3,243 hours.
Excellent. I'm going to be working most of those hours. That's pretty good.
Yeah. Making money.
I am actually getting paid.
Right. 194,610 minutes.
Not bad.
Oh, I got to take a breath for the last noise.
And?
11,676,630 seconds. Beep.
Nice. Done. That is our countdown for the end of the year. Nice.
You just scared the shit out of me with that.
It's like someone's slapping you in the back.
I did. I was like, "Ooh, it's earthquake!" I got this earthquake app on my phone. It's pretty badass.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really like it.
Oh yeah, you posted that a couple weeks ago when we had that.
Yeah, I like have a lot of fun with it. It's cool. I just look up. I mean, here, let's look it up right now. Let's just add that, just like right now, because it's our show. We don't give a shit.
Sure.
Here it is. Okay, 3 earthquakes today. And I only because it could be everywhere, but I filtered it.
To this area.
To like this area, I mean, a little farther, I put like, I don't know, 2,000 miles or something.
Oh, okay.
3.6 earthquake in Cantwell, Alaska.
Oh, you did put some mileage on that.
Yeah, it's 2,452 miles away.
Yeah.
And there's a 3.0 in Ridgemont, California, which is 272 miles away.
Yeah.
And I noticed a lot of activity in this place, and I didn't know they had earthquakes.
Where's that?
Oklahoma,
the Midwest. The flyover state.
If I look at it, there's always earthquakes in Oklahoma. I had no idea they had them back there.
Yeah.
And it was a 3.2.
That's healthy for there.
And it was only 3 miles deep. So it was rather close to the top. And it's only 1,100 miles away. So it's closer than Alaska. So I just thought, you know, everyone needs to know that. It's some information I love to share.
That was very interesting, yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't that interesting.
Well, it's like when you hear about an earthquake in the Boston area, you know, a few years ago. You know, they'll have a trembler. And you just don't, your brain, it's like us having a tornado. It's unheard of.
Yeah, but when we have a tornado out here, mm-hmm. I mean, it's like everyone's all freaked out, and it's like just blow some trees and shit.
Right, but I'm just saying, it's just not the demographic for that action, that part of nature. You know, right. Tornadoes, you think in Midwest. Hurricanes, you think in the East Coast.
Yeah.
Earthquakes, ours.
Ours. They're right. Don't take them from us.
Right. But when we have a downspout during a hard rain, we're like, oh my God, it's a tornado here. Massive coverage. Same with like a trembler in Boston, or even New York had one a few years ago. So.
Yeah. And it was freaky.
Yeah, exactly.
They all freaked out. What the hell is that?
The only one who knew, only people who knew what was going on, of course, were the transplanted Californians. Yeah, that's a small earthquake. You guys are fine.
And they're all freaking out.
Yeah.
They're talking all big badass like New Yorkers, like, we ain't afraid of shit. Oh, God, the ground's shaking. And into it. I ain't scared.
That's it.
I think, you know what we should do?
What's that?
Are we gonna bring those guys in?
Well, I was, actually, we're close to a break. We want to take a break and we'll come back.
We got something special. I post something about some special guests coming in.
Okay.
And we're going to do, Jimmy named it. It's awesome.
I named it for you.
You named it.
Well, it's your new segment and stuff.
Well, no, it's our new segment.
Well, we'll bring it in. Let's bring it in after the break. We got the break coming up.
All right. It's after the break. We got a couple people coming in to share it with us. And it's called Back in the Day Countdown.
Nice.
So I know you all are like going, holy shit, what are they doing?
We're doing
anything. Oh, man, since you've been gone, you kidding me?
We're doing anything.
We're doing it all because it's our deal. Eric's not going to be till 10. As a matter of fact, when he comes in, we might tell him get out.
Just go. Turn around. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for trying.
How was your gas mileage?
It's a bitch, wasn't it?
All right. Enjoy the Burbank Comedy Festival.
Wow. We're going to get out of here for a second. We'll see you guys in a minute with what? Back in the Day Countdown with a couple special guests. And that's all I got.
We'll be back.
See you in a second. Jimmy count me down and just goes, to hell with it. Take it.
I'm looking at you right in the eye trying to count you down. I'm like, here, I'll lower the volume. Jump in there.
Jump in when you feel like it. Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy thing here on chaoticradio.com. As you know, I'm Roy Brewster, and this is Mr. Jimmy Shaw. And we're here on Tuesday night having fun. And you should, you know, if you're listening, you already know that. But
live in Rancho Cucamonga in the beautiful, luxurious, well-accommodating chaoticradio.com studios.
Damn right it is.
We have lush leather chairs for our guests, a couple of nice upholstered ones for me and you.
A couch.
Two couches at least.
Well, there's two, and then a chair that's as big as a damn couch, and stuff over the walls and lights everywhere.
Yeah, just a beautiful studio that impresses every guest who walk in. They say, oh my God, this is not a kitchen.
No.
This is pro stuff. Right from the go. Don't forget the chaoticradio.com app available for your iPhone, your Android. It's free. It's awesome.
Hold on, man.
Jeez.
Go ahead, Jimmy.
Anyways, yeah, iTunes Store, Google Play Store, whatever you get your stuff on your Android. Shut the door. So, for free, great app. Listen live anytime, anything that's on the air. And then go to chaoticradio.com, listen live there. Also, the podcast for all the previous shows. And to keep him down or I'm kicking him out.
I know. I'm sorry.
Run it. We just talked
Jimmy,
about
finish
how
your shit.
We're a professional.
I know, and this is what we have.
All right. You just tell him.
No, it's shut up or
tell him.
Go, Jimmy. Right. Go ahead.
Anyways, chaoticradio.com, listen live online on your laptop. Tower, if you're still doing that thing, and all the past shows podcasts are on there. Look at the schedule, but all shows are also available on iTunes. Subscribe if you do, please leave a review. It helps everybody get their good ratings, and you can listen to every show there. Ours will be up before 8 o'clock tomorrow morning from tonight. We try to go prompt, quick, boom.
And why it's going to be up? Not, and I'm not going to pull any bullshit. I mean, when it comes down to it, they're prompt, quick, and up because Jimmy gets it done.
We get that done.
Shut up! Hold on.
One more time.
You're freaking done.
One more time. Anyways, so that's our couple. Check out the schedule. A variety of shows. New shows coming all the time. And your favorites, always.
Dude. I'm sorry. It's probably not a good idea.
Not a problem. I was done anyways.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Maybe it wasn't a good idea.
It's okay.
All right.
It's new. He's new here.
I know, but you're all settled in the other side, right?
Yeah. Sit down. I didn't tell you yet.
Okay. Right, so we've got our special guest coming in. This is a new thing we were talking about, and everyone's talking about like all the movies and all the cool new shit. You know?
Well, sometimes we can't get out and see all the new blockbusters.
And I can't.
You know, we got our day jobs, we got commitments.
So a lot of bills. Us rely, you know, I mean stuff either we've watched it then when we didn't have as much going on.
Right.
Or man, you know, you go hit Netflix and find one of these once in a while.
Exactly. When you come across, you're like, oh my God, this came out 5 years ago. I'll watch it now.
So we were talking about what we're going to do with it. And I think as a public service only, we wanted to have someone review some movies from, you know, quite a while ago. From how long are we going back, Jimmy? What do we say, 10 years?
I think we're doing a 10-year. Because most of the people are watching these now as classics. But they didn't know what it was like when they came out.
And some younger adults may not have, you know, 10 years ago, if they're 20 years old now, they were only 10 at the time. They couldn't have seen it if their parents were any good.
Right.
They, you know, because it's the way it worked. Is that my turn yet? Dude, shut up.
Hey, Louis, keep it down.
Dude, stop with the guy. Hey, Jimmy, stop that freaking guy.
You see the polo?
Jimmy.
Hey, not your turn.
All right, geez, this is probably not a good idea. We're going to do it anyway.
Damn, monkeys in the zoo.
We try to give some people some airtime.
And then this is what they do.
And this is what happens.
They shit all over it.
So we decided to go 10 years.
Okay, 10 years. This is the back in the day countdown?
Back in the day countdown.
I got to find some cool effects for all this.
Yeah, because if we continue to, I don't know, if they keep acting up, we're not going to continue to do it. Not going to happen.
Yeah.
You're going to find some effects now?
No, I'm just saying.
Oh, I thought you were looking at me.
Saying to be really professional.
So August 21st and August 28th, so it's 2 weeks, The 40-Year-Old Virgin was the number one blockbuster movie.
The 40-Year-Old Virgin.
Right, 10 years ago.
That's a great movie.
10 years ago.
That's 10 years?
Can you believe that?
That's amazing.
10 years.
I want to talk about the Virgin.
Dude, in just a minute.
Did you tell him that's him?
Yeah, it's probably you dumbass.
It's more like the 60-Year-Old Virgin.
All right. I don't know if I can. Yeah, we can do it.
All right, we'll set this up then. Let's do this here. Let's play the trailer.
Okay.
For the 40-year-old virgin.
Two special guests with the 40-year-old virgin.
So this is what happened.
Play the trailer. Trailers. Awesome. That's a good trailer.
All right, here we go.
Dude, the music's killer in it.
And that's retro for them.
I want you so bad.
Over the years...
Did you glue this? I wish I had some scissors.
Ow!
Andy Stitzer has lost a lot of girlfriends.
I'm sorry.
But there's one thing he never lost.
Are you a virgin?
Oh, you are hilarious. this is good.
You're a virgin!
How can you go 40 years and not have sex?
I just... can't stop trying.
We gotta help the man. We cannot let you go on being a virgin.
That's funny.
You gotta highlight your attributes. Just wax that whole Teen Wolf thing off.
No, Kelly Clarkson!
You look like a man-o-lantern.
The problem most men have is they don't know how to talk to women.
What am I supposed to say?
Nothing. Just ask questions.
Are you looking for something?
Is there something I should be looking for?
We have a great section of do it yourself.
Do you like to do it yourself?
What am I talking about?
You gotta go somewhere where every girl is looking for a guy.
Welcome to Date a Palooza.
I'm Andy, and you are Gina?
Gina. Hey, what's up?
Okay. I like your shirt.
Shh. You have kind eyes. You wanna get out of here? Do you think I'm pretty?
Whoa!
Look at me! Look at me!
I'm looking at pretty!
Universal Pictures presents...
I'm Trish.
Andy. She gave me her number.
It's gonna be my turn.
A comedy. Stop. About the wisdom that guides us.
We've given you all the advice we have to give. Now you gotta put it in action.
The friendships that unite us. And the experiences that touch us.
Maybe we should hold off on the physical part for a while.
Like we've never been touched before.
These trailers were long.
Hey, man, she's got a big box of porn for you.
I don't want this stuff, okay?
Andy, for the last time, I don't want your giant box of pornography.
No, come on, man. That is so uncool.
Uncool is trying to give an honest man a big box of porn, Andy.
The 40-year-old virgin.
All right. Audio trailer, obviously, in person would be.
I was enjoying it from here because I remember the parts of the thing.
Yeah, exactly, because we've seen the movie.
So we're gonna bring in the... You got him ready?
Got him ready.
You got him ready? We're going to bring in the guys. They're going to review this movie from 10 years ago.
10 years ago.
It's called Back in the Day Countdown. We need some good music for this shit next time.
Absolutely.
That is, if they don't work this time, to hell with them.
It's totally on them right now.
Right. I'm glad Blaine's not here. He wouldn't let him in the room.
No.
That was kind of a good plan on our part. A big plan on our part.
So my turn. My turn, yeah.
Yes. It's going to be your turn.
Yeah, are you ready for me? Hey. Hey. Hey.
So if you're wondering, we have local celebrity, Dennis.
Yes, to be already go.
Dude, not yet. And we have Rocky Balboa.
Hey. Do I punch him yet? What do I punch him, Mick?
All right. Okay. So we're reviewing the movie. Do you guys understand that?
All right. So we watched the movie. Now we tell you what we thought of it.
Yo, what's the matter? What's the matter with you? You don't understand what we're talking about? You're punching a faith too many times. Stupid faith.
Hey. Why you got to get all violent?
I'm not violent. You're just stupid.
You're violent.
You look familiar.
You know what I do to those guys?
What do you do?
What do you do, Mick?
You know what you do, Rock.
What do you do with that?
I punch him like a piece of meat hanging in the locker.
You're lucky you're in the other room, stupid face.
It's only glass.
Hang on. I'm a local legend.
Hang on. This is my favorite song.
Shut up. You probably a virgin.
Remember this song, kid.
You need to be quiet. We're talking about a movie.
This is what you're going to hear after you piss me off some more.
I'm going to hear it. I'm not going to hear any.
Adrian
was ugly.
Oh.
Adrian was ugly. She had a big nose, and you probably had to take her glasses off to make it look like you could kiss her, and she couldn't even do it. And I bet she
was. Mick,
I bet.
Hold me back.
Hey,
Mick,
I bet.
You're a rock.
I bet she with Harry.
You're a beast, Rock. She Save with, it for the ring, Rock.
She with Harry.
I'm gonna kill him.
Dennis, dude, don't be talking about his woman. That shit's not funny.
You're not gonna knock it off.
I don't care. She would probably had a
lot. My Adrian.
She had a lot of hair
That's
and armpit. Shut up. But don't move. So, 40-year-old virgin, as I used to watch.
Hang on, hang
I got
on.
It from Red Box.
Hang on. This is a good part.
I'm gonna talk about the box.
That's my ringtone.
Your ringtone, it's your head you hear, and you stupid asshole.
You're going to hear this after I punch you right
you're
in the
face. You're going to hear nothing. You won't even see me.
I'll punch you right in the face.
I'll hit that old man next to you, Mickey asshole.
Me and Adrian both are going to laugh at you laying there.
I'm going to laugh at Adrian. She put her arm up. Look like You know what she looked like when she put the arm up?
And
look.
Then that tall blonde broad from the fourth movie is going to finish you.
You know what she looked like when she put her arm up? Looked like tarantula on an armpit.
That's a big bitch.
No. Adrian have armpit hair.
Don't talk about my Adrian. She's an angel.
Stupid. She was in The Godfather. She was better. She's not Adrian. She's playing an actor. Wait a minute. I saw you in another movie.
Grace walking the earth.
Wait a minute. You're not just the Rocky guy.
Don't talk about my Adrian.
Wait, hold on. You do other movies. You do other movies too.
You park outside.
What? I rode my bicycle. I rode my bicycle, asshole.
Mick's going to want to talk to you.
Rode my bicycle.
Right, Mickey?
Hey! I've seen you in other movies. You used to wear a headband in another movie.
Oh yeah. You got to keep all this. You got to keep the shine down.
What the headband? What was it? Rambo.
Oh, that was a whole different story there.
Rambo.
That was more of an autobiographical kind of flick.
That was
the real Sly Stallone right there.
I have seen.
If you want to know what the real Sly, don't look at Cobra. You can kind of look like an Expendables 2. That's kind of me. And the Rocky ones are just kind of getting you ready for
it. I've seen Rambo, but I saw Rambone 2. And Rambone was in the Red Tube. Red Tube with Rambone.
Yeah, you're that guy in the back
and,
behind
you know,
the
let
curtain.
Let me tell you what
you're
happened.
You're behind the curtain in the video
let
store.
Let me tell you what happened. Because I know Rambone wasn't you because you got a small wiener.
Hey.
You in your boxing shorts.
Rules.
There was nothing there.
Two rules. You don't talk about my sweet Adrienne. You don't talk about my goddamn winner, Mick. I'm gonna kill this guy, Mick.
I saw it before in the movie. You made porn before that. It you was know before face, the Italian stand.
You're the only one I'm gonna feel bad for hitting in the face because your face looks like it's mangled already.
Your face looked like a punching bag, just like Adrian's biscuit.
I trained.
Adrian's biscuit looked like a
running up and down those stairs to make people look like you. After I fight him. And now I'm going to make you look pretty.
You can... What?
I will make you look pretty. I'm going to hit you so hard.
How does that work? Come hit me.
I'm going to. I'm not going
to
hit you.
I didn't want you to hit me, but now I want... If I'm going to look pretty, at least I'm not going to look like you, you stupid Italian.
Hey, I look great. They even put an article up this week. I'm cut everything. 69 years old. Still kick your ass.
69 years old. 69. He said 69.
69, brother. That's how I'm living. That's how I've always lived, with my life and my women.
With your life and your women.
And that rhymed.
With your life and your women, you had a tall girl that you couldn't stay with that dated a football player, and then you had Adrian.
You don't stay with a girl like that.
Well, then why were you with her?
Hey, you stay as long as you can, but get out when
you know
can.
Why? Because you wasn't man enough with your little wiener to be big or happy.
That's why you liked
Adrian, because she was a little girl. She was small, like an old woman in a little face.
She's a sweet little angel.
And then the other one was 6 foot, and she used to big men with big things and not with you. She's nothing.
I'm going to kick this kid's ass. I am going to kick your ass.
Jimmy, stop that. Jimmy.
All the way to...
Jimmy, they're supposed to be doing a freaking radio, a 30-year-old virgin thing here.
Hey, this kid is just... Sorry.
Jimmy, get him under control.
Rock, you good? You good?
I'm sorry. I'm still going to cool down for a minute.
Dennis,
40-year-old virgin. I saw that movie. I was almost...
You okay, Dennis?
I was up for that part.
I'm all right. He doesn't scare me. The piece of nothing.
I was up for that the Seth Rogen part. The delivery guy with the goatee.
Who? You could not work. I saw you in the... Cobra movie, you try to have facial hair. You look like a big ball sack.
It looked like it was painted on. It's not my strong point, this facial hair stuff. Knocking it off other people, that's what I do.
You put it on your face, it looked like chocolate milk.
Chocolate milk. You're a good kid. You're a good kid.
You're not very smart.
All right. So, 40-year-old virgin.
Oh, 40-year-old virgin. It's about the guy who rides the bicycle.
Well, first of all, I don't think the storyline was plausible because I, like many Americans, many Italian Americans, I lost my virginity at 9 and a half.
To your grandpa. Oh, to Mickey right there. Mickey stole your virginity from you.
I'm not going to get mad at you anymore, kid. You know why? Because you got a lot of homophobic thoughts.
Because I'm smarter than you.
You got a lot of homo thoughts.
Hey, you were the one in the shower room with Mickey.
You're talking about my wiener. You're talking about my girl's ugly. So you're anti-girl.
I'm not anti-girl. I'm anti-ugly girl with hairy armpits.
Pro-wiener. I'm just saying, just putting out the right.
I'm pro-wiener because my wiener is a pro.
You're right, Rock.
Nothing yours. You're amateur status with your waiter.
So I thought it was a very entertaining movie. Steve Carell pulled it off. He fit the part perfect. A couple stuff wasn't unbelievable, but hey, we've all seen Jimmy Shaw in action, right?
Hey, Jimmy.
Keep me out of this.
Jimmy, stop that guy.
Keep me out of this.
This is about them.
All right.
Well, here's the problem, because you got the porn video that was probably your original porn video in there that they were selling to people and no one wanted to buy it, and then you wrote the stupid movie about boxing with the guy, the Apollo, with the big muscles, and then he kicked your ass anyway. But you went the distance, so why? You do got your ass whooped.
I'm not proud of my early work, but the success of Rocky, which I wrote and produced myself, first time, spurred the sales of my porn video. And I'm okay with that. It's just money in my pocket.
Can you write me a movie for my porn video?
I'll write you a movie.
I'll give you a movie, you stupid ass.
It'd be Rocky 2, Part 2. You play the part. Who did I kick ass in Rocky 2?
Rocky 2 with Clubber Lang.
Okay. Who?
See, I know more about the stupid movie you did. Cause
I'm
you,
a Clubber, Eugenics.
Stupid face. You don't even know your... And then what was the third one with the...
Hey, I got hit in the head a lot.
I could tell your face looked like a punching bag.
It still looked good, buddy. Yeah,
what about the movie, stupid?
Movie. Very good. Steve Carell, like I said, he nailed the part. The cast of characters, really carried it.
He nailed it.
My favorite part was the girl coming in and on the speed dating. Said, Eugenia. She said, no, Gina, what's up? That made me laugh. One thing with the movie though, not a lot of punching.
I don't care.
Not a lot of punching.
There were punch lines in it that you didn't understand because you've been hitting the head too many times.
Needed more punching. Like if they hit the 40-year-old virgin every time he didn't get laid when they set him up on Easy Lays, that would have been
Lays is a potato chip.
Not that far. What was your take on that there,
I thought it was a good movie, but I like baseball better because I like to get the foul balls and take them over to get free coke.
A League of Their Own, that kind of movie? That's what you like?
No, because you probably can't get free coke. Because
you got a uniform like that? You little skirt wearer?
I wear a skirt better than you could wear a skirt.
Oh, I'm sure you do, yes.
I don't know if that was a good thing to say.
I'm
not sure. You know why I have to wear a skirt long, though? Because I got a bigger wiener than you do. And it would be swinging like a ding in a ding-dong bell.
All right, elephant penis. I'm going to give you that one because I don't want you to prove it.
I'll show it to you.
I don't want you to prove it.
I'm going to show it to you. Hey. Dude, Jimmy, this is not going anywhere.
They're just yelling. A bunch of kids.
Come outside, you piece of no good nothing with your old man. Get him out of here. I don't know if we're going to try this again. I'm glad Blaine wasn't here.
Mick's going to kick your ass. I'm just going to put you in the car.
Punching bag face, get over here, because you're not... Dude, just get out. I don't care if they fight. I don't care if they fight in the thing. You need a wheelchair for Mick?
We're gonna have to screen our guests next time.
Jesus criminy.
These guys.
Dude, I don't know. There's our back in the day. That was like back in the day, back forever.
Well, it was good to hear from Dennis again. And we already know Rocky's keeping himself good.
I'm calling you!
Is he still here?
Dude, enough.
Still here?
I think he's... gone. No, there he goes.
And he's gone. He fell down.
Oh, shit, man. We can have Eric at the top of the hour. We got Eric coming in?
Yeah, Eric, he hit me up. He should be here probably within the next 10 minutes or so.
Well, let's take us a short one because those assholes took up like 20 minutes of our time.
Yeah, I'm going to line up our little sponsors here, get us all rolling. I want to hear from King C over here at TSI Transcripts.
Oh, yeah.
I love that guy's voice.
Yeah.
We will not take, what is that, cheating party videos? Come on, that's the fun of it, King C.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, we got some got some sponsors here. They got to pay the bills. We'll line that all up. We got Eric coming in.
We're going to wrap this shit up.
Yeah, it's going to be quick.
That was an hour, just me and you. Oh, and those two jacks.
Those jack-offs.
Yeah, whatever. I don't care. I don't know. I think we'll ask them back. Dude, what are we doing? Getting all mellow now? Hey, man. Low?
Bring it down a little bit.
I needed that.
I needed that to clean the mess up in here.
Clean the mess up in here. We're going to get foul balls. We're gonna take a break here on the Roy and Jimmy thing.
Don't harsh my mellow, man.
I'm not harshing it.
Just go with it.
It's quiet. It's Roy and Jimmy thing here on CaticRadio.com. Get us the hell out of here for a minute, Jimmy. We'll catch you after the break.
Starting from zero, got nothing to lose. Maybe we'll make something. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove.
Well, didn't we have fun there, muting me, you son of a bitch.
It's funny to watch you singing. You know what? Never love me again. Welcome back to the Roy and Jimmy thing here on chaoticradio.com. We got our studio cleared out. We're waiting for our buddy Erik Escobar, and we got those idiots out here.
Yeah, we have a parking space reserved. The red carpet is out. We have makeup artist on hand to get him prepped and ready for radio.
Yo, we got makeup artists here?
For radio, sure.
What the hell's our problem?
We're on radio.
We still look like this shit anyway.
That's it.
We had Eric in here before. Well, you know, we're going to intro on some Eric stuff. This is Eric's views.
Eric's views. That's what this is called?
Yeah, Eric's views on the 420 shit.
Already.
I actually found out 420, National Pot Smokers Holiday, is also Hitler's birthday. That's crazy. Makes sense, because both stoners and Nazis would want to celebrate with a good burn.
Ooh.
That's two Holocaust jokes, guys. We've maxed our Holocaust limit this set. Okay, let's move on to something more cheerful. Let's do that.
So either that or we go to Eric's poop jokes.
What to do when you're stranded in a city and need a last-minute hotel? A Priceline tonight only deal.
Are you kidding me? Freaking ad. There we go.
Jesus.
Hey, guys. Why not? Here are some poop jokes, okay? Hey, recently I was taking the best poop of my life when I realized I missed my bus stop. Oh, boom, poop joke number one. You ready for poop joke number two? Yeah, that's right. I went there.
Is he doing this in his bathroom? Is this like practice?
Because poop is spelled exactly how it is. You know what I mean? Like it begins with a P. It ends with a P.
With a ooh in the middle.
You know what I'm talking about? Dude,
it's the best part. He's just going to be telling it with it.
I actually like how he just jumped into his bit.
Hey, guys.
And started finishing it up.
You know, we're going to do another one. Oh, we're going to make him jump into this one, too.
Oh, no.
Yeah. We're going to do another one. Let's see if he goes.
I actually have an uncle who's great. He's an older guy. He's in his 70s. And he just learned about planking. Remember that fad from like 2 years ago, but he loves it. All right, he's been planking on our kitchen floor for the last three weeks.
Look at that simulcast, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eric Escobar.
Hey,
what's going on, brother?
Hey, so first, Steve Jobs. I know you're dead, but I have a couple words for you, Steve. So Apple Maps said it would take 30 minutes to get here from Costa Mesa.
Dude, you were out there.
Dude, you're way out there.
It was not 30 minutes to get here, so I'm blaming Steve for that. I don't know who to sue.
He didn't give a shit.
He doesn't?
No, right now, he really don't care.
Am I going to get that money?
Yeah, he can't give a poop right now.
but here's the deal, though. I mean, you could try to sue Steve. You can go after it.
I'll sue him. I'll see what happens. I'll give you guys a report.
So you fell victim to the Apple Maps.
Yeah, I usually go Google Maps, but yep. Today I did Apple Maps because I was like, hey, you know, I go support the apples. And and it was horrible. Oh, geez. But I got to have a nice little drive. I drove by Angel Stadium.
Oh, pretty. And it was
very pretty. Very beautiful yes. at night. I drove by Disneyland right as the fireworks went off.
Look at
you. Did you stop and look?
Yes, that was 45 minutes. I
stopped for 45. You may want to thank him for the scenic tour.
Yes, I will.
You hit landmarks. You hit historic places.
I'll write my congressman.
Scenery. Well, I found out with Apple Maps when I got my iPhone 5. I did not know Apple Maps was zip code specific.
Ooh, well, I didn't know that till now.
Yeah, me and Sean Williams, we had a show in L.A. And it was like Olympic Boulevard, so I type in what they told us. And it took us to Olympic Boulevard, but near downtown. Or actually on the other side.
Oh, Olympic's a big street, right. too.
On the other side. We're in a Ralph's parking lot where a comedy show should be going on. So we spent an hour there realizing that's not it. Had to go against traffic back to the actual Olympic Boulevard. And it was actually, we were there probably an hour and a half before that because it's right there where the 10, the 60, the 101 happened, Olympic. Yeah, so we didn't miss the show. We still got there early, but learned a valuable lesson on zip code specific for the Apple Maps.
You should have started your own room at the Ralph's.
We had we almost was because we had to do comedy that night. We're maybe simulcast it.
How do you like them apples? And
so yeah, so
so Steve Jobs.
To this day, that's a little thorn in Sean's side because he was driving and I was doing the navigation and I let him down.
Don't worry. I let him down,
but that's what we learned. But I use Waze.
Waze is good. Oh, I like good.
Waze. Only because it has the alternate routes.
I like Waze. The only thing that is weird about it is I feel like every time I'm on it, it redirects me every like 2 minutes. It'll be like, hey, go down here. It's a faster way. And it'll be like, whoop, go over here. It's like, oh, I didn't make the U-turn in time.
Yeah, frustrating. Yeah, it doesn't keep up sometimes. Yeah, the exit just passed was your best one.
Now, I have a problem with Waze because it makes me feel obligated to interact or I'm not doing my part. It's like vehicle on the shoulder. Is it there? And then you don't see it. And you say not there, and then you pass it.
And then you're like, screwed over everyone.
I just screwed everyone behind me.
I feel like there should be.
Not everybody, but.
And you can't do it anyways. It's illegal.
To get in a car accident?
No, the respond, you can't use your phone while you're driving. So if you're solo driving, how do you respond to a car not there that they said vehicle on shoulder?
Interesting.
See, it's kind of where they get you. You feel guilty, but you also feel good you didn't break the law.
Or you can just have one of those days where you don't give a shit about everyone. See, like, car on the shoulder, and just block all the traffic up.
And then you can get to your place where you need to be.
Right, because everyone's like, I ain't going that way.
That's how I got here from Costa Mesa. I just sat on Waze that all the traffic was there and just whoop, whoop, whoop.
Well, you did make it in, so we do appreciate it, buddy. You hit me up last week, said I'm going to be in town, and of course, you're welcome anytime, my friend.
Hey, and how bad is that? You just came off the stage in...
We were looking at your Instagram.
About 40 miles ago?
Yeah, Roy said, when do you think you'll be here? I looked, and the first picture on Instagram was you on stage, and it said 2 minutes ago, and Roy goes, oh, shit, he ain't going to make it.
I made it.
Yeah, I made it. And then you messaged me, said, dude, I'm on my way. I'm like, this is going to be great. So, not awesome.
I'm very hyper right now. Have you guys ever like been in a little bit of a rush and you've been like, oh, I need to like be here, and you finally get there and the rush hasn't calmed down yet?
It's like coming down from it's like coming down from a show.
Well, it's that plus the cocaine.
Obviously
there is that.
Right, you know, at least it wasn't a meth come down, so you're good there.
No comment.
You have too good a teeth.
These aren't dentures. These are not dentures at all.
You're running good. So how have you been, man? We've missed you. We haven't seen you in a while.
I've missed you guys, man. It's so good to be back. I love you guys. I love Chaotic. I love this show.
We haven't seen you. Last time we saw you was the La Luna show in April when we did the Roy and Jimmy show. Victor put on. I think that's the last time I saw you.
That was a good show.
Oh, it was a blast, dude.
That was such a fun show.
So you and that grandma, you guys hooked up? You had a good night?
Yeah, we had a great time. We did it, and I'm going to be a father. So it'll be
nice.
It's fine.
Well, you moved up north.
I have. So I live in a little town called Occidental. There is 1,100 people that live in the town, and we are two blocks long. Closest gas station is about 20 minutes away.
Wow.
So I am out in the boonies.
You green acred that shit.
I did. I green acred hard. it's a great place, but what I think is so cool about it, at least as a comic, is they have a comedy scene out there, which I only think is proof that it doesn't matter if you're in Los Angeles or New York City or you're in the middle of Montana or the middle of Arkansas. Like, everywhere you go, you're going to kind of find family and someone else in, like, the brotherhood or sisterhood.
Well, yeah, I noticed that when you got up there, I think within the week you already were hanging out with two people at shows, open mics, and really – and just hitting it quick. You didn't, like, sit down and get stagnant up there at all.
No, I knew if I – were even to hint at stagnantity, then I would just say
it's a word.
That was a good pull.
Smart.
If that's not a word, it'll catch on. I liked it.
Love it. Well, hashtag starting now.
Starting now. Week. Yes.
But I knew if I were to start chilling, then I would just chill. I knew it would be the longer I waited, the harder it would be to motivate myself to get back up. So I started going to a couple mics. You met some great people, told about other mics, other great shows. And within a few months, it was amazing. I was getting to perform all over the Bay Area. And what's awesome is, I don't know if you guys know Brian Blanco.
I was going to say, yeah. you started hooking up with our buddy Brian. Yeah.
Brian lives out there. And then Jeff Kazanjian, he's an LA guy, really great comic. But it's just so odd that two wonderful, amazing people who I kind of came up with and saw shows when we were all starting out, they're doing comedy now in the Bay.
Right.
And it's just – I think there's something so beautiful about just the community of comics in the world.
Oh, absolutely.
Because you could literally move somewhere and make a couple calls and a couple text messages.
Right.
And be like, oh, hey –
well, Blanco,
you guys are up here too. You guys are in town for a weekend. Let's do this.
Yeah, and Blanco's up from up there. He just recently went back.
Yeah.
So he's got the Laugh Gang up there and them putting on shows, him and Andrew and David. And so they're always putting on shows. And then they come. In fact, they're coming down tomorrow. You're doing a show with Brian.
I'm doing a show with Brian tomorrow.
Tomorrow night. Yeah. Him and Andrew are coming
so
down.
So odd. Yeah. They're coming. They are troopers. And I think a ton of comics out there are hustlers and troopers. But these guys are driving down from San Francisco, doing two mics, doing the show we're on. It's Get Weird Wednesday, Slide Bar in Fullerton. Come on out. Good little push. And then they're doing the midnight mic over at Flappers.
At Flappers, yeah.
Which is the plan. And it's like, then they're heading back.
Nice.
They're literally driving for 7 hours, doing four mics.
And heading back. Doing the turnaround.
Got to do what you got to do. It's
nice.
Beautiful.
Nice. I noticed that Blanco was coming down, and I hit him up. I hit him up to see if him and Andrew were in town now that they come into the show.
Yeah.
And he said, no, we're coming down tomorrow morning. I'm like,
damn it.
So close.
It would have been great to get the mom, because I feel like Bronco's a really fun guy who's just like super great to hear, and he has a lot of great stories. But Andrew, whose name I still can't pronounce, Arufalo or Orofalo?
Orofalo is usually what I go with.
Let's go with Andrew Orofalo. He's super funny, super awesome, and I think that, you know,
he's like chill, but he's not, and the long haired kid, you know.
I will forever know him by hearing this joke that he said at a mic we did together probably about a month ago. Oh, God, I'm going to butcher it. And Andrew, if you're listening, I'm sorry if I'm butchering it, but it's so good. I have to put that out in the world, giving you credit. It's along the lines of, he took a dick pic and the guy got so angry. It was like, oh, my God, what a great joke. And for not knowing the guy and that being the first thing you hear out of his mouth
into
a group
classic.
Of people who are just drinking in this dive bar, it was like, I like you.
I actually met him. He was he came down a few times and did the open mic at Flappers on Sunday nights.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, he came down, did a couple weeks. And so I got to meet him through Brian, obviously, and stuff. So a really good guy and stuff. We've been keeping in touch. Yeah, so. Yeah, I'd love to have them both in here.
It was a great – I think we met kind of at that mic, but we met prior to that maybe, I don't know, a month or two before at this great room in Oakland called Drexel. If you're in the Bay Area, check it out. A guy named John Lawrence runs it, and Bryant Hicks. They're great people. But I remember he was hanging out. I just don't remember the night because we were getting a free bar tab. So it was
Sure.
It
gets fuzzy.
I remember he was there. But
a little fuzzy.
Yeah. A little fuzzy. Fuzzy navels everywhere. Is that a drink? Is that a manly drink? That's a drink.
It could be. Sure.
We'll make it a thing. Just a PBR and cough syrup.
You can actually yeah,
mix it up.
You can actually end a night of drinking with the fuzzy navel, because at that point it's like, look, go. They're just cheering you on.
It's just a shot out of my navel.
Don't open with the fuzzy navel. Close with it.
Yeah, my fuzzy navel's just pulling the lint out of my navel.
But it's delicious. But it's a great, it's a tasty time. I've had second rounds many a night.
Hey. I'm supposed to share.
Hey, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Well, as soon as you got up there and settled, you started doing shows, and you were immediately back on the road. I think you were going down to Phoenix.
Yeah.
I mean, no offense, but this is like the hardest I've seen you working since you moved. You moved and you started traveling and being everywhere.
What I find, and this is in no way a bash to being in LA at all, or I should say when I was in LA, my experience, is I felt like when I was in LA, my main focus was to get as much stage time as I could at any mic that I could.
Right.
And I think that it's really important for, you know, comics do that. You get to work stuff out. You get to learn. You get to read. You get to do all this great stuff. But since that was my focus, I felt like the road kind of came second to that.
Sure.
Because I had this great town and city that I was living in where I could, you know.
You didn't have to leave town. And, yeah.
Exactly. And have a great time, have great audiences, amazing people. When I went up to Occidental, or the Bay Area, I should say, I could drive an hour and a half to Sacramento. I could drive 2 hours to or I should say about an hour and a half to San Francisco, about 2 hours to Sacramento. But I was in a situation where I was used to going up all the time, and now I couldn't just because of the distance, or just because even because of the money, because when you have to pay for that gas and pay your little fast track right. 7 nights a week, that adds up.
Right.
So I started not doing any, you know, big shows or anything for a couple weeks, maybe even like a couple, maybe like a month or so, but then getting a lot of good road work. So I felt like I could compensate the time where I wasn't working, if that makes sense.
Sure.
And it's, I feel like it's a lot of hard work, but I also feel like it was a lot of luck. A lot of luck came with it. And just a lot of great comics helped me out. A lot of great clubs liked me enough. And it's been a blast the last few months getting to work the road, getting to feature, getting to
I'm sure it was a thrill, especially like you said, from being here for like 8 to 10 spots all the time at these places to be out in new, exciting, different places, different audiences, and you know, just running your craft on them.
It's incredible. A weird feeling that I felt was it was something that I experienced actually in Seattle about a year ago. They had, I think it was like a Wednesday night or a Thursday night, where they had a mic, and it was the only mic in town, and you got 3 minutes, and I went because I was in town, and like 60 comics showed up.
Wow.
And this one mic, 3 minutes each, and I was like, dear Lord, is it like this every week? And they're like, yeah, this is
the
one mic tonight.
This is the mic. This is stage right here.
And that's – it was like, whoa, that's crazy. And then moving up to the Bay Area – San Francisco has a great scene. Sacramento has a great scene, but where I was living specifically, it was that same thing. There are about 20, 25 comics within the area. And on Wednesdays, we all meet up at this great mic called Spanky's.
Yeah.
Why? Cause it's the one mic we can do. So we're going to take full advantage of that.
Knock that 3 minutes out the best you can.
Yeah. And it's totally different from being out here where you almost get kind of like, yeah, I could do this, Mike, but I want to watch the rest of Mad Men. Like it's
gotcha.
It's weird when it's not an option. That's when you crave it.
Yeah,
more.
Too many choices out here. I can see what you're saying. It's weird. It's too many choices that you don't choose.
Exactly.
You know, we're there. It's like this is the only time I'm doing it this week. I got to go to Spanky's.
So you got to. I mean, you focus on the time you have because it's not. You know, like you're saying, it's not all over the place.
You got.
It's all you got.
Right. Yeah.
Unless you're standing in front of the mirror.
Yeah. Exactly. Which is my set, actually.
Yeah,
that's it sounded awesome. They're like
nightly in my room.
There were like no audience members. It sounded on those two bits.
No, none, zero, absolutely.
You and a hairbrush.
Yeah, well, the hairbrush, you know, leaves during the middle of the act. You know, I throw it out of anger.
Yeah,
out of anger. Oh shit!
Yeah, looks like we got a phone call. If anyone's got any questions for us or Erik Escobar, it is 909-989-0789.
Line one, you're on the air.
Hey guys, what's up? This is Dennis.
Dennis, what's going on, man?
Hey! Yeah, I haven't talked to Erik in so long. I just see him on Instagram. And
he right?
Around. He's just like boom, boom, boom.
All over the place.
So, I just posted a moonshot and tagged all you guys in it.
Yeah, nice.
Moonshot. Well, it's a nice moonshot. Crescent. It's a nice bright crescent moon tonight.
To clarify the listeners, the moonshot is a beautiful thing. It's actually of the moon in space. Nothing. Yes. So you definitely want to see this picture. It's not of any of.
Yeah, I'm not moons. Just hanging a moonshot out a window or anything.
Yeah. Like no butts.
No, yeah. No cheeks. No. But no. We get into a few weeks of dark clouds at night. We may have to get that from you.
Yeah, well, it's white and shiny, but I don't know about black.
And it looks like it's got cheese on it too.
And I won't be near it pointing at it. So, Exactly. It'll be a solo shot for Dennis.
I've heard it glows. Yeah.
I heard it glows.
Yeah.
Dennis, I want to tell you something. You were a huge inspiration for me recently because very sadly recently I cut off my beard, but I had a beard for a second and boy, yes, oh boy, did. One day I wish to have a beard like yours. I just want to make sure. Right. That's
we all strive for that.
That's the life goal. Like, I don't want a sitcom. I don't want to be on HBO. I want D-Dub's beard.
D-Dub. D-Dub's. Nice.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, I noticed in that one picture you posted of your mustache.
Oh, right, curl it up
and down.
That's badass, dude.
Yeah. One way or the other? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the thing is,
confused much? Wow. Yeah. Anyhow, Eric, I'm glad you're doing so well up there, and we missed you down here, but glad you're doing good up there.
Hey, man, I miss you, and I'm following your Insta, I'm following your Facebook, I'm checking out all those great moonshots, and it's always
moonshots and Mila shots. That's all I do.
and they're both beautiful.
And
both
the date night dinners, yes.
Oh, the date night dinners.
Oh yeah, dinners.
I hope we go on for like 45 more minutes just naming things we're looking at Dennis's social media.
I know. Look at Dennis's stuff.
In 2008, you had a wonderful hat.
Wonderful hat.
Nice. I did, actually. No.
I did in 2008.
I just figured I would call and bring you guys into your next commercial break.
Yes.
And, it's not like you listen or anything and know what the hell's going on, right?
Exactly. And I just wanted to be able to call during the right hour and say, fuck, fuck, fuck. But other than that.
Nice.
Yeah, you guys take care. I'll talk to you later.
All right, Dennis, man.
All right, Dennis, buddy.
All right, man. Take care.
Thanks.
Man.
Bye.
Gotta love Dennis. Oh,
man. Miss that guy.
Gotta love Dennis.
That's bad. Hey, look, he knows it's break time. He already set us up to go to break.
He called me up. He texts me going, hey, Jimmy, you're running long. Go for the break.
Wow. Hey, thanks for looking out, Dennis. We would have just blown right
back
through.
Who's got her back? Dennis.
Dennis
got her back. All right, we're going to take a quick break, our last break, and we're going to shove 2 hours into the last 30 minutes with our buddy. 15 to go.
We'll get it back in a minute. You're listening to Roy and Jimmy Thing on chaoticradio.com. We'll catch you in a minute. Oh, and Great 8 coming up. Don't forget. See you in a second.
Gotta keep them separated.
Bear meow. You can't sing yet because it's a long intro.
All right,
gotta give it burn me.
It's coming right now. Here you go.
Like the latest fashion. Spreading disease.
That's also a new segment, Erica.
The kids are strapping on.
The Roy commercial come in, sing along.
It's great.
Dude, yeah. I loved it.
Yeah.
Come on, you can come in.
He can't help himself.
Do you have lyrics? I feel like you should just have a karaoke hour.
I think everyone would be so much better at karaoke if they had like that small earpiece. With the lyrics going on.
Are you talking to me?
Because you sing along in the shower or your iPod, iPhone, or whatever it be, with the song. But if you have done karaoke where they have it just, you know, scrolling with the ball or whatever it be, you can get yourself lost because you're not used to reading it.
Yeah, you have to have it like, I don't know, I feel there should be bands that do karaoke of their own song. They should also do the instrument of it. Like at shows, like I would watch that. Like I think that'd be a fun thing to watch.
Yeah,
that's great. A thing? Did I just invent?
It's a thing. You just invented it right here. You got to say the trademark now. Trademark Roy and Jimmy thing.
Trademark Roy and Jimmy thing.
Eric Escobar.
Hashtag Eric Escobar.
All rights reserved.
Hashtag all rights reserved. Hashtag Pornhub. I think we got it. We are.
That's everything.
You forgot the date. 8:15. 10:42 p.m.
That's actually the whole. That's the whole internet right there. He went from chaotic Roy and Jimmy to Pornhub.
I just got the whole
internet.
That is 99% of what's going on. That's the internet right there.
That's it.
Yeah, it's all of it.
Steve Jobs, listening up. Give me some tips.
There's your app.
been on for 10 minutes, and I've just had a discussion with dead Steve Jobs this whole time.
So how long are you going to be down here, buddy?
So I just did a wonderful show in Costa Mesa at La Cave. Tomorrow.
With an audience.
With an audience. Boy, oh boy. It's so weird. So I had.
Boy, oh boy.
Boy, oh boy.
Let me tell you.
Let me tell you something.
I have a very good friend who she actually saw me last night when I did a mic over at the District Lounge. Mm-hmm. And then she came out to the show tonight to watch. And she mentioned, and it's something that we all know, but we all, I think, forget sometimes. She noticed how it's like. It's so weird how you're doing the same set, but you get two completely different audience reactions.
Oh, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
And it like blew my mind because I think the more you go up, the more you just kind of get used to it. You're like, I'm doing my time. I'm trying to, you know, focus on what they want and focus on what they need. But mostly I'm just going to do what I got to do. But yeah, people are varied. I don't know why I brought that up. It was bothered me.
I'm glad you brought it up.
Just say, just venting. This is
well, my you know, Jesus Christ. Get him all the way out here. Get him on the freeway well, for 40 minutes. He gets all pissed off.
And start venting. It
brings everything you need to come. You know, stuff's got to come off your chest. And that's it's rare that any of us have two shows a night.
Yeah,
true. To experience that. Okay. And when it does happen, we experience that. Now, we've seen it with other comics. I know when I've gone to the Ontario Improv when I first started, one of our buddies and mentors was Kyle Cease.
Oh, yeah. He's great.
He's a great guy. And when he was at Ontario Improv and went to the first show, he goes, stick around for the second show. And that was probably one of my best learning experiences because I got to see all three of the comics on the lineup do the same thing different.
Yeah.
And that's just
some their, stuff still hit, some stuff didn't.
And their attitude and how they adjusted, I was in awe because I never experienced it that same day.
Yeah.
You know? You see them 3-4 months later, you're like, oh, that's a funny bit. I love that. But when you see it consecutive like that, I learned a lot.
There have been so many shows. I've worked a lot of weekends where you'll do your first show on Friday, 7 p.m., 8 p.m., whatever it is, full packed house, crowded. The audience is loving it. You couldn't imagine that it could be a better show. And the next show, 9:30, 10 o'clock, you got like two people in the audience.
Yeah.
And it's... there's something kind of beautiful about it because it kind of keeps us all on our toes.
It, yeah, really it takes you right from headliner aspirations to open mic night for the second show.
And you're this feeling. Is what I
got
to do.
I got lucky. I've said this before, and I'm bragging because it happened to me. I got the feature over at Claremont 2 years ago for Thomas Dale.
Thomas Dale was great.
And it was great.
I want to suck your tiny little dick.
And they let me feature the whole weekend. And so I got to experience that, and it was immediate. You can just see the adjustment, you know. And I used to be the type of guy, I think Roy also, you look at the crowd first before you go on.
Yeah.
And you know, okay, they're my age. Okay, they're probably like, I'll tone this one down. You're putting some you're premeditating your bits, and you're always wrong.
Yeah.
You're always wrong. So the second show on the Friday night was an older crowd. No, the first show was the older crowd.
Okay.
Loved it. Okay, had a great time. Second one's a college town. It's Claremont. They were all youngins and stuff. I go, man.
And they were probably already drinking the later show.
I may have to dial this down. And the show was almost full house. I mean, it was a good, you know, Claremont. So it was good size. It was good fill. They laughed just as hard as the older crowd first. And I had to actually adjust funnier to them. Actually kind of milk the bits more, you know, keep them going.
Yeah.
You know, and the same for the other two nights. So I actually had four different shows.
What I think is very odd about that is I feel like, and this is no bash to younger audiences, but I feel like a lot of younger audiences will laugh at setups and laugh at punchlines they may not get because they want to be involved and they want to have fun and they see their friends laughing and they're like, well, I'm
so they too. Just got to ride the wave in.
Exactly.
They do it because it's expected.
Where older audiences legitimately get it.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's weird because it's like two different types of laughter even.
Right.
It's like not even like they're both laughing at the same things. It's like, whoa, they're laughing for very different reasons.
Exactly. Like, and, you know, I'm right in the middle there. I got an older crowd. I got a younger crowd. I can make them both laugh and just tweak a little, mm-hmm. you know, and still say the same stuff.
You just crap me out, Eric, right now.
I just crap
you out. Yeah, I would just – at Claremont, the same deal, I got a show –
the college night.
The college night.
This is probably like four or 5 years ago.
I don't know. Maybe at least four.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, you. I'm like, man, I'm in.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
I was his bringer. I said, I'm going to this.
We're going.
I'm
going to watch this. Jimmy, you want to go? Jimmy goes. So I show up and I'm like, it's college night.
And they're kids.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
What the hell am I doing here? And it was like one of the best sets I've ever had.
It was one of your best shows.
Incredible. And it's like, how does that happen?
And he didn't pander down or anything. You know,
yeah,
you but see, that's why you crap me out. because I just found out they were laughing because they didn't get the jokes. They just wanted to have fun.
No, they just wanted to be as cool as you.
They just wanted to try to join
the Brewster fan club.
They had to up their game is what happened.
I'm all thinking like, yeah, I killed that. No, they didn't know. They just were laughing because they were drunk.
I was actually at that show and paid them off.
See, every single one. Thank you.
I told you.
I was like, Roy's a friend. I like him a lot. Here's a bunch of PBR.
I told you we met 4 years ago.
Oh, but to answer your question, I am doing a show tomorrow in Fullerton at the Slide Bar. Thursday, I'm at the Hollywood Hotel. Friday is the Lord's Day, day of rest.
Visit your mom and dad, pet the dog.
Yes.
Visit your mom and dad, pet the dog. How's your mom and dad doing?
They are great.
Tell your mom I said hi.
They are wonderful people. Last time I was here, I had a friend drive me out, and my parents drove me back home because I was crashing with them, and it was really weird because I say all this filth on this dirty show,
this
and then
raunchy.
I walk outside and I'm like, "Hello, mom. How?"
Yes,
are
right.
You?
She was sitting out. She was, and the speakers were on.
This is my career.
That's right. Well, and also that was kind of it was a good night, obviously, because you were here and we had a great time.
Amen.
Bad night because I think you sat on the 5 for an hour or so.
Yeah, I remember that. That
Look
was
at
horrible.
Look at all wound up. Yeah,
Steve Jobs. It is not 30 minutes to Torrance, California.
I felt bad because I'm only like 5-10 minutes away from here. I got home and I'm just chilling. I'm doing the wind down and I hit Instagram and it's probably 45 to an hour later. And you said, "Oh, fun times." You had video and everything. You were actually out of the car on the 5.
This is my favorite thing about LA. I've never been able to do it in another town. Maybe done a half dozen times out. Especially in the downtown area, traffic gets so bad you can actually get outside your car for a minute
and sightsee.
And just sightsee, grab a stretch joint with the guy in the next car.
Stretch your legs. Make some friends.
One of my
hang out.
First,
have a picnic.
Get on top of
one
a
of
hood.
My first hacky bits at an open mic was when I first started was about LA and because I used to not even go into LA.
Yeah.
And I would say, you know, me and the wife would hit the freeway. When we hit traffic, we treat it like a tourist attraction. Get out. Hey, this is a guardrail. Ooh, this is the 405. Take a picture of me next to the sign. That was an old bit I had. But yeah, you can get out and stretch. It's actually, I remember one time going up north and going through Malibu and there was a traffic jam. So we stopped, opened the cooler. We're there an hour.
Yeah.
And we just got out, said hi.
I remember I was going, at the time I was living in Koreatown, which is just west of downtown.
Because you're Korean.
Because I'm full Korean.
Full Korean.
I love dogs, and I don't have to squint in the sun. So I was on the 110. If you're familiar with it, I was on the 110 North, and then I go and I take this – it's a huge turnaround. I don't know what they're called, but it's like that big loop where you take a giant circle to get on the 10 West.
Right.
So, you know,
that's an on-ramp.
On-ramp. Yeah, that's what they're called.
I'm just checking.
So,
I'm here for you.
I get full on the on-ramp and then brake lights everywhere. It's stopped. No one can go anywhere. Wait about half an hour. Haven't moved. It's a parking lot. Then I start to see people back up on-ramp. Like, it started – I don't know who it started with, but it started with some people, and then people just started to slowly back up off this huge on-ramp between two freeways. And I was like, that is very L.A. Like,
yeah.
Oh, this We've is had annoying. It. I'm going to go now. Mm.
Well, you know they stopped because somebody had a flat tire. I mean, something major like that. That's why we stop on the freeway.
Yeah, and then everyone wants to see this flat tire.
Exactly. Even if it's on – it's before. So bad it's on the other side of the freeway, and we're still going to slow down.
This was actually on the 105, and I was on the 10 and the 110. It was
You're way back there.
Good bits.
Good bits. That's what they call fleshing them out. You got to work them out.
Work them out.
Fleshing them out.
Well, this is your 3 minutes up there in that little.
Yeah, place up there. This is my time.
See, this is all. I mean, think about it. 3 minutes. Hell, you've got like an hour.
Yeah.
Just go. We're just gonna sit back. Go. Come on. Go ahead.
I didn't know Roy had such a spotlight right there going. And
I did.
Now.
I scared the shit out of him.
I'm going to talk like that.
What else do you do up there? Do you have a job up there or anything, or what do you do to pay some bills?
I work part time at a summer camp.
That's right.
Really
I saw.
Great, but kids are the worst, aren't they?
What's the age range you're doing right now?
We work with children ages 6 to about eighth grade. So I'm gonna say that's about 14, maybe
13.
And actually they're really, really great kids. I work with a wonderful organization and they're awesome. But I feel now that I've had this job, I don't know if I've ever wanted kids. This is definitely solidified that I don't want like 6 to 10 year olds. I feel like,
I can put
them out just, you know, like in a box and then come back to them like Christmas lights.
So keep them till they're 5, send them to your mom, pick them up when they're 15.
There you go. Gotcha. I'll pick them up right here in the studio.
Well, you know what I'm thinking is you're going to blow up because you're everywhere. You're going to blow up big, have enough money, boarding school.
Ah.
See? And then they fix them during that time and bring them back when they're all proper and shit.
Oh.
Right?
There you go.
Where have the kids been? Oh, we're not going to talk about that.
They'll be back in a while. Sitcom.
And they'll feel great self-esteem because they're at boarding school. They're thinking your dad's loaded, got no time.
I've always been very confused because I always thought boarding school were just schools far away. But they're not. And I think maybe it wasn't until I was like 20 or 21 where I was like, oh, wait, boarding schools like actually have like a thing. Like there's like a culture around them where they have like to wear these things.
Yes.
These clothing, I think what it's called.
Clothing.
Uniforms.
There you go.
Finally made it. but yeah, I always thought boarding school was like really far away because my friends, we would watch movies where it's like, oh, we're going to send you off to boarding school. And I was like, oh, that sucks. He has to go to school in Ohio. What's so bad about that? Ohio seems fine.
Made it seem fun, a little out-of-town trip.
Yeah, I thought it was just like a good time.
I just think it's odd when you go out of town and you got to get rid of your animals, you send them to go get boarded.
Yeah, there
you go. Same shit.
Yeah, we'll see. I can make that comparison now. But
I'm going to send my kids to a dog hotel.
Right. Yeah,
dog
hotel.
Boarding. So basically, a bigger kennel.
Yeah.
To put your kids in.
Yeah, we'll see how good they are.
Well, I'm thinking you do it anyway because I when you take your dogs, they put them in a cage overnight, and then during the day they let them run around on the grass and poop, and then let them back in the cage.
I had a friend from Arizona visit me in the Bay Area, and the one thing that they said was super weird about California or the Bay Area or just where I was living is the amount of pet hotels, because I don't think that's a thing really anywhere else other than like parts of California. I don't know, maybe parts of the East Coast. I feel like they might have them, but yeah, pet hotels are a thing, and that's a weird thing. We put pets in hotels. Like we really care.
Oh yeah, and they're luxurious.
Yeah, it's expensive.
Yeah, expensive. They're opulent. I mean, the actual dog beds where they're shaped like human beds and nightstands, and I've seen some on TV that were just like over the top.
My first apartment in college was a 12 by 3 foot closet space under a staircase in Koreatown for $200 a month. Which is literally probably about a third of the size as some of these dog rooms that I've seen. And I'm like, that is not that you're paying more rent, but I get it.
Yeah.
I'm really depressed now.
Yeah. We just
you're upbringing. Brought this whole
The last 3 minutes has had a weird energy.
very weird. Remember all that excitement you had when you were coming in, when you were on the high
the
and everything?
Coke is coming down.
It's coming down right now. Mm. Hey, send somebody
I'll
out
do
to
diet
get some
next
more.
Time.
What's that, buddy?
Send someone out to get him some more.
There we go.
There we go.
He'll be wound up again. Freshen him up. Well, buddy, this is new since you've been here.
Oh, is this the eight? The grade eight?
The great eight.
It's a newer segment. We've been doing it probably about almost 2 months now.
Oh, boy.
It's called the Roy and Jimmy Thing Great Eight Quiz.
Great Eight Quiz.
These are eight questions.
I'm excited and afraid.
The answers, there's no correct answers.
Okay,
there's no right or wrong. They're your answers.
Kind of like a liberal arts college.
Pretty much. Same type of thing. Exactly. Whatever comes to your head, that's what you answer. And there's no points scored and no cash prizes.
Can I close my eyes?
You may.
I want to close my eyes for this. I want to concentrate.
Go ahead and close your eyes. Cameras are off.
No, I'm going to turn the cameras on when your eyes are closed.
While he's taking the quiz. The concentration.
Cool. The concentration. I'm going to see the furrowed brow as you're thinking it out.
Wait, are you guys recording this? Because on the video, because I think we should all record. Oh,
I could.
We weren't. No, I thought you meant, are we doing currently? No, we're not right now. You can if you want.
I could record. Let's do this. I was going to record myself. No, I was going to record one of you recording me. Then we'd all post it at the same time.
Well, obviously you and Roy are in the eye line right there.
All
right.
Perfect. My mom's calling me on Facebook.
Hi, Mom.
Well, say hi. Bring her on.
Oh, God. I think I just hung up on her.
Oh, Jesus.
Not accidentally. I'm sorry, Mom. I just thought it was...
Come on, Mom.
Is she in the front room waiting for you?
She's in the front room waiting for me. She's
yeah,
picking,
that's why she's
my ride.
Say, I'm going to get
you. She's working for Uber now.
Mom's an Uber driver.
All right.
She's working for Uber now.
Whenever you're ready.
Okay. Whenever you guys ready. Tell me.
Three.
We're ready.
Okay.
Two.
One.
Welcome to the Roy and Jimmy Thing Great Eight Quiz.
Great Eight Quiz.
Tonight's contestant is comic Erik Escobar.
Yeah. Escobar.
Erik Escobar, are you ready for the Great Eight Quiz?
I'm ready for the Great Eight.
All righty. Question one. Letterman or Leno?
Letterman.
Wow. Nice. Fast.
Hands down.
Hands down. Number two. Your chill music, your go-to getaway music.
I'm going to go with Circle of Dead Children's second album, Deathcore.
Okay, wow, wait. That's a first. Is that like is that a for real thing?
Yeah, let's look it up. Can we play some Circle of Dead Children?
Yeah, we will.
That's why I'm going to look it up right now.
You're making some shit up.
I was going to say, what the hell? This is not an open mic. Okay, give me the words again.
Circle of Dead Children.
Circle of
Dead Children.
Okay, there they
are. My favorite track is Bring Her a Mushroom Cloud, Part 2. Part 1 is great. Part 2, I think, is
It's right here in YouTube. Let's bring it up here.
It is really right there.
Yep. Okay, let's see here. All right. Bring her a Mushroom Cloud from Circle of Dead Children.
Yes.
Part 2.
Part 2.
Part 2.
Not part 1.
The song's Part 2?
Yeah.
Well, it's there. Bring her a Mushroom Cloud. Oh, it's a live version.
This is chill music.
This is what gets me in the relaxed tone.
And as guest, the lead singer, bald as hell.
Yeah, go figure.
That's me during a really rough time.
Okay.
It's not me during a rough time.
Well, there we go.
There's your chill.
I'm going to tell you right now. First answer we've had for Circle of Dead Children.
Very first.
But not the last. I will guarantee you that. I would say
from now on, not the last. Yeah. They're going to be saying, hey, what was that shit that Erik listened to? That's what I'm going with.
Yeah.
All right, number three.
Yes.
Your comic inspiration.
Oh, God. Dimitri Martin, Steve Martin, Emo Phillips, Anthony Jeselnik.
Okay.
Those are the top four. And you probably just asked for one.
Those are
the top guys.
Are you enjoying? Have you watched any of the last comic standings?
You know what? I haven't. And I want to for multiple reasons. One reason, there's a ton of great comics on there. Watch it. Support it.
They're this amazing. Year, I know there's a lot of people we've worked with.
Mark. What's his last name? He's so funny. He does the deaf spelling bee joke.
Yes.
Yeah. Mark. Google Mark Spelling Bee Death.
Death.
But your buddy Anthony
Jeselnik, he's hosting
stuff. Yeah, doing a really good job.
You know what? I think that's great because he had a great show on Comedy Central called The Jeselnik Offensive, and it was so funny and so wonderful. And they canceled it for whatever reason, and I was really upset because I was like, oh, fuck. Anthony Jeselnik is one of my favorite comics, and I want to see him do amazing things, and I know he will do amazing things, but this was his shot, and they're taking it away from him.
Oh.
When's he going to get his next big thing? And then he got the host of Last Comic
Standing. Yeah, he's doing a great job. It's totally huge, enjoying him.
Huge.
Okay.
Norm MacDonald's also on it. Norm MacDonald, another huge
influence. I like him on there because he tells people they suck.
Yeah.
They do.
I didn't enjoy it. No. Smelly like a Swiss cheese in the sun.
Exactly.
He just stares at them for a minute.
All right, number four.
Number four.
Your go-to comedy movie.
Go-to comedy movie.
Ooh, Mystery Men.
Mystery Men, really?
Mystery Men. I'm a huge Ben Stiller fan, and I want to say that was one of his – The Cable Guy was the first movie he ever directed. I want to say Mystery Men was like the second.
Yeah?
And I love Mystery Men. Blue Raja, Invisible Boy, Janine Garofalo. Ugh. Blah, blah.
Nice. Gah.
There it is.
That's how I feel about it.
Number five, and I think we already covered this. Last thing that pissed you off. Minor, major, doesn't matter.
Last thing that pissed me off. There's no cucumber in this water that you gave me.
There you go. That's my bad. It's in his writer. That's my bad.
It's in my writer. I also don't know where my coup d'etat is. That's coup d'etat?
My bad. My bad. Slap on the wrist.
Jimmy.
I'm sorry, sir. Next time. Number six, your pizza leftovers, cold or warmed up?
Warmed up in the oven, not in the microwave.
See, we've had another of those answers.
See, more than I would think on the warm up. That means you care. You take the time.
Well, it also, I would say a big game changer is what's on the pizza.
Yeah.
Because I will eat a cold Hawaiian pizza and be totally fine.
With the pineapple, everything works out.
Exactly. But if there's ever like an extra cheese on the pizza, if there's ever like a, we put like little mozzarella things on there, ricotta things on there. Or if it's a margarita pizza, you can't have a cold margarita pizza.
Gotcha.
Those are warm in my
mind. We've learned a lot because it was Rick. I can't say his last name.
Iscetta.
Martinez. He fries it. He fries leftover pizza, puts it in a frying pan. So I tried that the next weekend. Dynamite.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I assume the bottom would get warm and nice and crunchy, but the top would stay cold.
It warms up. It actually remelts a little bit and doesn't kill it like a microwave does.
You know, a little life hack here. I do this with my burgers. I'll get the meat, and then when it's pretty cooked, put the cheese on top, put some water on the pan, and cover it with like a...
Yeah, you steam it.
Steam it. You steam it. I feel like you could do that with the pizza, like steam it a little bit and then get the cheese a little twister in the mouth.
That's something like it, but we're learning so much more on the leftovers.
We talk about food a lot when I'm on the
show. Every show.
Every show, pretty much.
This is where it gets fun.
A lot of food.
All right.
Number seven, your favorite cuss word.
Oh, cunt.
Nice. Wow. I like it. Cunt. Little Bill Burr style right there.
I feel like people don't say it enough, and I feel like it's one of those words.
It's not a woman thing.
It is a woman thing.
But it's not when it's said in
yin and yang.
When it's said in madness, I guess. Or
I feel like the thing with the C word is that I think it's one of the last words that still kind of like gets people a little like, ugh.
Uncomfortable.
Like if you say like shit, they're like, oh, whatever. If you say like fuck, it's like, oh,
yeah. Right. I know where you're, it's one of those bad words that people actually stop and go, oh shit, he's so pissed.
Yeah.
Because shit and fuck are really kind of lost their shine.
And it has such a punch to it.
Yeah, exactly. And it's just like, oh, he's over the top now. The C word came out.
Wow.
I got it.
It's a good one.
All right, buddy. The last one. You ready?
Drum roll.
The last question of the Roy and Jimmy
last
thing.
Question.
Great eight quiz. Number eight. What is your best impression? Could be someone famous, could be someone you know. It doesn't matter. But what is your best or favorite impression that you do? Everyone does one. So you can't
Erik Escobar. Erik Escobar is my best impression.
No, there's somebody else. There's somebody else.
Oh, geez.
Yeah, just anybody. Oh, God, but you do one. Everyone does one.
Everyone does one. I feel like I'm getting frustrated myself right now because I can't.
Well, you just did Norm MacDonald, so everyone's got something.
You know what? I'm going to answer this completely sincerely, and this is kind of a bullshit answer, but I hope we can roll with it. It would be my roommate, Mac Fiskin.
Nice.
And I like a lot of people like big like actor impressions or like comic impressions or something like that, and those are all fun and really exciting. But I had a roommate named Mac who was so – he had so many mannerisms and he would do things that were total Mac things.
You're right.
He would be with other friends and they would like do this weird thing where they would like put their arms out all crazy. And you're like, oh, that's like a Mac thing. He had so many weird little things about him. Like he would,
so got trademarks of his deal. That's what he does.
He would constantly get frustrated and like push his hair back with his hand, but leave it there through the conversation. So it wasn't like he would like push it back and like all the hair would go back and his hand would be done in his pocket. No, he would like, it would go back and it would just be like, oh, like that's horrible. I can't believe you. And he would just stay there 5-6 minutes of the hand on his head. When he would be frustrated, he would put his arms out really grand, like he's trying to scare off a bear. It was great. And he had all these weird little things, and I love the guy. He's one of the most brilliant, funny, amazing people I know, but he had the most mannerisms of anyone I've ever met.
All right, let's have him.
Let's have him?
Yeah. Let's have a little piece.
How about this? I am going to be Mac, and I'll let you guys interview me. You can interview me as Mac Fiskin for the next minute. Does that work?
All right. All right. Cool. You up for it?
Yeah, why not?
You interview Mac.
Yeah. So, Mac, I hear you had this roommate named Eric. And, I mean, he talks highly of you.
Yeah, like all right, so here's the thing with Eric. He likes to, like, I don't know, the kitchen is never fully, like, yeah, man.
But what about the kitchen?
Yeah, the kitchen, the microwaves too, dude. That's what I was saying.
Does it like bother you when he warms up his pizza in the oven other than the microwave?
Man, see, like, ovens are crazy because, you know, you turn them like 350, but is that even accurate? Like, maybe it's like 351, and does that mess up? Like, what if, like, the lean cuisines, they're really specific. You can't mess them up. So you gotta put it in the right. I like Eric, man. Jeez, pizza. That was Mac. Like, that was hilarious. He kind of, no! Mac, that was nice. For you.
good stuff, man.
I am no longer going to be seeing him after the show without getting a butt whooping.
Yeah, but he'd do it with his arms out with love.
He would do it with his arms out, and then
it's an easy.
It would be a one-handed fight because his hand would constantly be on his forehead.
It's an easy fight for you with his arms out and one on his head.
He's in Thailand right now.
Oh, you're fine. You're good.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you're good. They don't have radio over there, right?
They probably already caned him a few times for having his arms out and his hand on his head. So.
But they do have internet there, so he could be getting it.
Oh, he could be.
Could be.
Probably not.
chaoticradio.uk.th. dot happyending.com. I don't know how their URLs work in Thailand.
That was the Great 8 quiz recording.
That was great.
And you are recorded.
I posted part of it.
Nice. The part of it?
I posted.
Of me holding like this?
Yes.
That was like classic,
that
right?
That was 20 minutes ago.
That was a great. Actually, you know what? I didn't know the Great 8 quiz would take that long, but it was 10 minutes and 41 seconds for that Great 8 quiz.
That's not bad. Minute That's very good. 20 per question.
Excellent.
Look at you with your math skills.
Yeah.
No wonder you lived in Koreatown.
Yes.
Or China. What was kind of Chinatown?
I live where a lot of places.
Same shit. You live in Occidental now.
Well,
I live in Occidental now, which is, you know what's weird about Northern California? Not a lot of Asians. It's been very hard for me to adjust because I grew up in Gardena, which has a ton of Japanese people. I've always grown up around a lot of Asian friends, and there are no Asians in Northern California. It's weird.
They're all down here.
They're all down here.
Well, now you look like a little dog. Now you look like a little Italian gelato salesman now, so you're good. You got the hat and the stash. You're good.
Everyone's telling me I look like Mario.
You do. I didn't want to go there. I'm sure you got it. I went gelato.
I like shrooms. I like... killing turtles. I'm fine with that.
I like banging my head up on blocks. It's good.
Yeah. Shit. I like rescuing princess eye. I don't know. What's the plural of princesses? It's princesses.
Princesses.
We made it.
Right to the end.
Well, unfortunately, Big Eye, this is it. We're done.
Hey, man. It was a great time. I love being here. And I have a couple friends tuning in. And
shout out. Do the shout out.
I don't know who's tuning in. I just know people are tuning in.
Oh, good.
Let's look it over here. Now I can get it really, really quick. It's, I got a minute. I think my mom's listening.
Hey, mom.
That's great. Hello. I think Rachel might be listening. Daniel is listening.
Nice.
Cameron is listening.
You sound like Hobo Kelly, like from my era.
I see Billy.
See, look, it's before his era. He's like, who the hell's that?
That's why I jumped in there.
Well, no, I'm just looking through my texts of people who are like, hey, I'm going to catch you. And me being like, I love the freeway.
No, that's awesome. So tomorrow night, though, you are going to be, say it again.
The Slide Bar, Get Weird Wednesdays. Bubba Sanchez is going to be there. He runs a great show. Brian Blanco
Brian returns to SoCal and Andrew.
And Andrew, it's going to be a wonderful time, and I'm just so happy to be back in LA and so happy to be around amazing people like yourselves while I'm here. It's been perfect and beautiful. I'm
glad you made it in, buddy. It was great to see you. Thanks for hitting us up that you were in town. Like I said, anytime
you
drop in, you're in town. You come on through.
That's awesome. I'm coming out to see us. That's cool. I know your time's limited, and you came out to see us. That's badass, dude.
Well, hey, if you're ever in Occidental,
I just had a thing from somebody that says, when are you going to go up north? When am I going to go up north and do some stuff?
I'll book you in a room in the woods.
In the woods.
It'll be my mirror. It's the Eric's mirror room.
I get to use your hairbrush?
You can use a lot of things.
There we go.
You'll be in the woods. Time. You can do anything you want. I did want to give a shout out to Scott Shimamoto. He was in last week.
Yes, Scott.
Super fun. Next week, we got Zhivago Blee in.
Oh, whoa!
So that's going to be a fun show.
Comedy Revolution. Stand-up Revolution.
That's it and stuff. Yeah. So, again, Eric, thanks for coming in, man. I know you hauled ass and you did some work tonight and still got it here. So we do appreciate it, man. Always a great time seeing you.
Appreciate it. Look at he's ready to fail.
Done. He just said nothing.
We said none and we're done.
He thought we were off the air.
We're done. I ain't gonna talk to you guys anymore.
Hey, guys, I'm actually on my way to another mic right now. Oh, I got to be in Florida in 45 minutes, so I'm going to get in the car.
That Coke's going to help.
Put on some Waze.
Awesome.
Put on some Waze.
All right, buddy. Roy, we'll see you next week, next Tuesday night.
Next week, everybody. You've been listening to the Roy and Jimmy Thing here on chaoticradio.com. You guys have a great week. Love you all. And hit them, baby. That was you, Melissa. Thanks for reminding me. Have a good week. You, girl.